So good morning, guys. We'll start the today's good morning test session or daily current affairs session. So it is indeed a good morning for America also. So finally, Donald Trump has vacated the office, and Joe Biden and Kamala Harris have taken the oath. So how many of you saw the inaugural ceremony yesterday? Why? Yeah. Okay. We'll see today. So let us start the today's good morning test sessions or daily current affairs session. So I welcome you all again. I welcome you all, those who are in online also. Hi. So okay. So let us start with the first question for the day. The first question is, with reference to ancient Sanskrit text in India, Sushruta Samhita is a text belongs to which of the following genre? So it is a text regarding what? It is a text regarding medicine and surgery. So recently, our health minister, Harshvardhan Singh, decided to name the plastic surgery block of AIIMS hospital into Sushruta block. So they have just named that block in Sushruta's name. So what is the significance of that name Sushruta? So for that, we have to come back to history. So in history, we are having art and culture. So in preliminary also, art and culture plays a very important role. So in the part of art and culture, we are having two important physicians in the ancient India. One is Sushruta, another one is Charaka. Charaka and Sushruta are two important physicians. Sushruta had expertise with respect to surgery. So he is also considered to be one of the most ancient surgeon also. So he wrote a in detail treatise. So Sushruta Samhita is nothing but a Sanskrit treatise in detail about surgery. There are thousands and many hundreds of procedures and as old as rhinoplasty. Rhinoplasty means nose replacement, nose adjustment. Cinema heroine la pandrangala. Those kind of rhinoplasty and all also he has suggested in his book. So that is the ancient surgical book. So Sushruta lived before the Christ. So that is 6th century, 5th or 6th century BC. We don't know the exact date. We are just having an assumption that he was from 5th to 6th century BC. But Charaka is a person after Common Era, that is from 2nd century AC. So Charaka in general wrote about the therapeutics and therapies. What are all the different kinds of therapies and what are all the various diseases and what are all the various therapies, how to cure the diseases. So this is the work of Charaka. So they both are physicians, but he is surgery and Charaka is general therapy. So that is the difference which you have to understand, because in options they can give that side also. They can also give the surgery and therapy in the answer. So this is the statue of Sushruta. They started this new burns and plastic surgery block in AIIMS hospital, which will focus on curing the burn injury and the plastic surgery for those who are having the burn injury. So that is the main focus of this block. Since he is considered to be the father of plastic surgery, they have named that particular block after him. Okay, so this is one statistics we can, if at all there is a question regarding disaster management, fire accidents are also part of disaster management. So in mains, so there can be a question regarding fire accidents also. So in that time we can use these stats. So there are 70 lakh burn injuries every year, 1.4 lakh people die. Of the 70 lakh, 1.4 people die because of the burn injury. So Sushruta is from 7th and 6th century BCE. So he has given details about 300 surgical procedures, on 120 surgical instruments. Regarding instruments also, he has given the details. And this book was translated into Arabic by Caliph Mansur. So Caliph means he was the religious head of Muslims. So at that point of time, so only after the translation of Caliph Mansur in 8th century, that this book got the world fame. So after it was transferred into Arabic, then it went to Europe. So once it went to Europe, it got its fame. So the next question is one of the controversial topic of discussion with respect to Indian politics or social justice, whatever. So it is about the reservations, especially with respect to promotion. So we all know the reservations got a major turn after the Mandal Commission judgment, which came in 1992. So according to that judgment, reservations in promotion was not allowed. So Supreme Court said that SC/ST people can get reservation when they are applying, and OBC people, but there is no provision for reservation during promotion. Promotion appo irukka kudadunu they gave the judgment in the Indira Shahani case or Mandal case. So what happened then? But government had the intention to give them the promotion. So what government did? They added an extra article called Article 16. So the article was, just a second. Article 16, 4A. In Article 16, 4, we are having this provision for giving the reservation for SCST community, or they won't mention SCST, the reservation for socially and educationally backward community. Article 16, 4 gives the provision. 16, 4A was added to give the reservation during the promotion. So that 16, 4A was added in 77th Constitutional Amendment Act in 1995, which introduced 16, 4A that enables the state to make any law regarding reservation for promotion. So 16.4 deals with, it enables the state to give promotion during the joining of services. But 16.4A gives provision for, it's an enabling provision for giving the reservation during the promotion. So that is the difference here, joining the services and during the promotion. So it is just the enabling service. It doesn't mean that reservation is right, fundamental right. What they are telling is, government can make a provision for reservation. So they are just enabling the government to make a provision, but they are not mandating the government. They are just giving the power to government to give this. So it is just an enabling provision, not the fundamental right. That is what the Supreme Court also observed. So this 77th Constitutional Amendment Act was passed in 1995 in order to bypass this Supreme Court judgment in Indira Sahni case, which said that reservation should not be given during the promotion. But again, this after this act was passed, and again this issue came into the Supreme Court in Nagaraj case in 2006. In Nagaraj case 2006, Supreme Court upheld that promotion, the reservation can be given during the promotion, but it brought in the creamy layer concept. So Indira Sahni brought in the creamy layer concept only for the OBCs. It said that for SCSC, we don't need creamy layer. But in this Nagaraj case judgment, Supreme Court brought in the creamy layer concept for SCSCs for promotion, not for the joining time. For the promotion, we have to bring in the creamy layer. So it also added another provision that if at all we are giving reservation, it gave three conditions. The first condition was, just a second. The first condition that if at all a government is giving reservations, it should provide data regarding the backwardness of the community. It should first show that this community is backward. The second condition is it should also show that this community is not adequately represented in the government. And the third data is it should also ensure that this reservation will not affect the efficiency of administration. Okay. So all the three conditions should be passed, then only a particular community can be given reservation in promotion. So what Nagaraj Singh case said, you can give reservation in the promotion for SCSC community. We are upholding that, but bring in the creamy layer concept. So the creamy layer should not be given the reservation. In general, SCSC are not having a creamy layer concept during the admission, but they are having during the promotion. But then it added other three criteria. Show the data for backwardness, show the data for inadequate representation, number of people in the services. And finally, they also asked them to ensure that efficiency is not compromised because of reservation. So under all these three conditions, you can give reservation and promotion. That was in Nagaraj case. And then again, someone appealed against this, and again it went to Supreme Court in Jarnil Singh case. So Jarnil Singh case took place in 2018 only. So 2 years back only the judgment came. In the Jarnil Singh case, again Nagaraj case was under the question in Supreme Court. So in Jarnil Singh case, what Supreme Court said was, no need to show data for, it upheld the creamy layer concept for promotion, but it said that no need to provide any data because we all know SCST community is backward. We don't need any data. It is understood. So the first condition was removed. The second condition is it also said that they should not be inadequately represented. That criteria also, it said it no need. We can give them promotion, but we will also apply the creamy layer concept. So 2018 judgment states that for reservation and promotion, creamy layer should apply. But another writ petition was filed against it because government is having the intention to remove the creamy layer concept for SCST people. Government is not willing to have this creamy layer. So since government is not willing to have creamy layer for SCST people, it filed a case to remove that provision. So that case is hearing is going on now. So that is the story. So now Supreme Court is hearing that case. Now another judgment can come. A larger bench can sit and finally decide whether the creamy layer provision can apply or not. Now it is applied, but the case is going on. So that is what the current affairs regarding this. I just gave you a timeline. Okay. So once you are reading it, again, you are reading this GMT and opening and reading, the entire thing will be explained here. Supreme Court directive on quota on promotion. Supreme Court gave a directive to the government recently. So that's why it was in news. So 77th Constitutional Amendment Act, 1995. So that statement is true. Constitutional bench in Jarnil Singh case 2018 upheld the requirements of provision of quantifiable data mandatory. So it didn't upheld. It said the data is not required. in Jarnail Singh case, so one only is the answer. It's clear? So in the reservation promotion, Punjada, இது வந்து ஜஸ்ட் ஒரு டைம் லைன் தான். பாலிட்டியில எந்த ஒரு கான்ஸ்டிடியூஷனல் இஷ்யூ படிச்சாலும் யூ ஹேவ் டு ஸ்டடி லைக் திஸ். த டைம் லைன் இஸ் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். யூ ஹேவ் டு ரிமெம்பர் தி கேசஸ் ஆல்சோ. சோ இட் சுட் கம் லைக் திஸ் வென் யூ ஆர் ரைட்டிங் யுவர் ஆன்சர். லைக் ஹவு ஐ வாஸ் எக்ஸ்பிளைனிங் தி சேம் வே ஆல் தி கேசஸ் யூ ஷுட் ரிமெம்பர் வித் ரெஸ்பெக்ட் டு டைம் லைன். சோ ரிமெம்பர் ஆல் த டைம் லைன்ஸ் இன் லக்ஷ்மிகாந்த் வென் யூ ஆர் ஸ்டடிங் தேல் பி கிவிங் த நேம் ஆஃப் தி கேசஸ் அண்ட் தேல் ஆல்சோ எக்ஸ்பிளைனிங் வித் த டைம் லைன் ஒன்லி. சோ வென் எனி திங் இஸ் டிஸ்கஸ் லைக் தட் ஜஸ்ட் ரிமெம்பர் இட். சோ நோ காம்ப்ரமைஸ் ஹியர், ஜஸ்ட் ரிமெம்பர் இட். Because while writing answer, you are you are not having any time. You have to just write in the flow. So now this Jarnail Singh case is under the question. So everything whatever I discussed is only is explained in the explanation. You can read the explanation once again in order to recall. Okay. Now let us wait and see what is the final judgment coming. So the next question is regarding the India Innovation Index. So who released the India Innovation Index? Okay, I showed the answer. So Niti Aayog released the India Innovation Index. So generally, I already said Niti Aayog is trying to bring in the what kind of budgeting? Outcome-based budgeting. So for outcome-based budgeting to be implemented, you need data, you need indices to measure the outcome. So on that line, Niti Aayog is developing a lot of indices to measure the outcomes. So there was a school education quality index. There is index regarding water management. There is an index regarding health management. So for education, health, for everything, they are making an index. Similarly, they have brought in an index for India Innovation Index. How well each and every state of India fare with respect to the innovation. So Niti Aayog also brought in another concept called competitive federalism. We all know cooperative federalism, where union government, state government should cooperate. But competitive federalism means two state governments will compete with each other for ranking. So competition will lead to good efficient results. So in order to bring in this competition among the states, they have brought this index where they will be ranking the states based on the amount of innovation they have brought in their particular state. Amount of innovation, various laws enabling the innovation, and various laws easing the patent filing procedure, all those things. Any fund, whether it has created or not. So it was released by Niti Aayog, and which state topped the ranking? Karnataka is in the top. Followed by Maharashtra, then Tamil Nadu is in the third. So earlier Tamil Nadu was in the second, now Tamil Nadu went to third. Vetri Nadai. போடும் தமிழகமே அந்த ஆடுக்கு ஏற்ற மாதிரி தமிழ்நாடு வென் டு ஃப்ரம் செகண்ட் டு தேர்ட் த ஸ்டேட். ஸோ இட் இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் சர்க்கேசம். ஓகே, யார் மனதையும் புண்படுத்தல. த ஸ்டேட் அண்ட் யூனியன் டெரிட்டரிஸ் ஹவ் பின் டிவைடட் இன்டூ 17 மேஜர் ஸ்டேட்ஸ் அண்ட் 10. ஸோ இட் தேர் நாட் ரேங்கிங் ஆல் தி ஸ்டேட்ஸ் இன் த சேம் லெவல் பிகாஸ் ஆல் தி ஸ்டேட்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் சேம். டெல்லி ஸ்டேட்ஸ் அண்ட் நார்த் ஈஸ்டர்ன் ஸ்டேட்ஸ் ஆர் ஹவிங் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் எக்கனாமிக் கிரைடீரியா அண்ட் அதர் ஸ்டேட்ஸ் ஆர் லார்ஜ் அண்ட் தேர் ஹவிங் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் திங். ஸோ தேவ் கிளப் தி 17 லார்ஜ் ஸ்டேட்ஸ் டுகெதர் அண்ட் 10 நார்த் ஈஸ்டர்ன் ஸ்டேட்ஸ், டெல்லி ஸ்டேட்ஸ் அண்ட் 9 city states. So the city states means Goa, Sikkim, they are city states. Just one city is only the major area, another thing or small thing, and then union territories. So Karnataka is ranking first with respect to larger states. Himachal Pradesh ranked the first with respect to hilly states, and Delhi is ranking first with respect to union territory. Just remember the first, that's it. No need to remember anything else. Maybe you can remember the last, Bihar, because somewhere if you are writing any answer regarding regional inequality or development or anything, rural development or regional inequality, regional disparities, you can use this last state in order to compare with the first state and in order to ensure that there is inequality, we have to bring equality. So in such kind of point, you can use the name of the last state also. So what are all the various things which was measured? These are all the 5 indicators. Human capital formation. What is human capital? How well the human being is acting as a capital. So how education is being provided, how healthy is and how educated she is. So with this, they will be doing it. Then investments with respect to innovation. Then knowledge works. How many patents are coming? How many new innovative ideas are coming from that state? Business environment. Whether a new idea or patent is being converted into a business. There might be 1,000 things, but that patent should be working. We also discussed in editorial. Safety and legal environment. So legal environment cases related to this. So this is India Innovation Index released by Niti Aayog. So just study all these indices. See this again, News on Air. So one thing I observed regarding News on Air is the news is in News on Air is coming a day ahead of PAB. PAB la poradhu or naalik munadi idla potranga idla oru pudusa undu ivanga munadiye vandu information poiyudhu naalik indha index varapodhu ivan potta innikku dhaan nethikku dhaan mundha nethe News on Air la vandu nethikku dhaan PAB is posting that index is released today. So News on Air analla the GMT edukkara Prasad dhaan, he told me this. So the next one is Gucci mushroom. So Gucci mushroom is a species of fungus. So mushrooms are fungus, so larger form of fungus. They are not from plant, fungus is found in the temperate forests of Kashmir. So Gucci fungus is a special kind of a fungus found in the Kashmir. They are asking for a geographical indication status. So this is the Gucci fungus mushroom. So it will have the scales like this, ridges. So they are asking for geographical indication. It is very costly because of its medicinal properties and for the consumption also. Geographical indication tag has been sought. They are just asking. It is not being given. They are just asking. So UPSC can confuse here. They can give in massive following or in a question as if they have given it. Since we read this with respect to geographical indication, we'll get confused that they already gave it. So they are just asking for geographical indication. So whether we have to wait and see whether they gave or not. So GA tag has been sought for one of the most costliest mushrooms in the world that grows in Jammu and Kashmir, Doda district. So how many geography options are here? Rindu, Moonu, Nalu, okay. So geography options, what you have to do? They are just telling one of the costliest mushrooms of the world in Jammu and Kashmir is Doda district. So how you have to prepare for that map question? You saw that map question, it came in the second paper. You have to note down this Doda and go and see where this Doda is located in map. So like that only you have to prepare for map. Map questions coming from current affairs for optional, I'm telling. You have to mark it in the map. So you have to Google where this Doda is in the map and identify the point and mark it in your map book. You have to have a map book separately. So you have to do that. So I'm just telling you to do this map work also. Because if anyone who is getting 20 out of 20 in the map, then that person's mark will be proportionately increasing for all the other answers also. It applies to history also. Average, my maximum is 14, 7. I've never got 10 out of 10. Maximum, I've got 7. We'll talk about that later. So it is 20,000 per kg. After the class, we'll discuss. It is 20,000 per kg. So it is as costly as that. So follow this news, whether they are giving or not. It is growing in the clusters of logs of decaying wood. And it is having medicinal qualities and anti-inflammatory properties. So Bear Grylls, if Bear Grylls finds it, he will take it and squeeze it in order to find. He will also eat it directly. It is also rich in protein, carbohydrate and vitamin B. So next question is regarding meerkat. So with respect to geographical indication tag, you just note down. So we cannot study all again. Just study those in the current affairs. There will be just 15, 10 or 15 in this year's current affairs. Just study those which state what is the quality. So these are all the three things which have to study with respect to GA tag. GA tag is given in order to ensure that the local artisans are getting the rights. No other person should grow it or no other person should produce it. So that particular name of Gucci mushroom will be given only to them. Like Kanjipuram silk is a Kanjipuram silk only if it is being weaved in Kanjipuram. You cannot weave a Kanjipuram silk in Chennai. That should not be called as Kanjipuram silk. It is Chennai silks. Vivaha. Okay. Next one is Jokel. Meerkat. So Meerkat one, it is a telescope located in South Africa. Sorry. So Meerkat is a telescope of South Africa. It recently detected two radio galaxies. So that's why it was in news. So it is operated in South African Radio Astronomy Observatory. So these kind of questions will come in match the following. Instead of asking like this, they will take another two telescopes and they will ask match the following. Meerkat, South Africa. They can give country or they can also give their technical capabilities like radio telescope or microwave. Enna wave la telescope irukku, they can also ask. So note down like that. Its capability to detect faint diffused light makes it possible to detect the giant radio galaxy. So it is having capability to detect even minor signals. So we can detect, the distance of detection will increase because it is having capacity to detect even the faint and diffused light. Okay. So what is radio galaxy? So we all know how we are able to see the objects because the objects are emitting light which is entering into our eyes. We are having something called visible spectrum. Light is also a radio wave only. It is also an electromagnetic wave, not radio wave, electromagnetic wave. So in that electromagnetic wave, particular spectrum is a visible spectrum which we can see, but it is a very large spectrum. So radio waves are also electromagnetic wave, but which cannot be seen by us. So now also this room is fully filled of radio waves only, but we are not able to see it. So there are certain galaxies which will emit radiation, but the visible light wouldn't have reached there. But that radio spectrum of that particular galaxy would have reached. By detecting that radio signal, we can detect the presence of the galaxy there. So it is those galaxies whose radio signal has reached there. It is not, which means that they are emitting tremendous amount of radio signals, radio energy. So rather than the visible spectrum, they are emitting tremendous amount of radio signals. So that is the meaning here. So those galaxies which are having tremendous radio signal output are called as radio galaxies. So discovery of two new giant radio galaxies. So it is 62 times larger than Milky Way. So that is the recent detection. So this Meerkat is a group of almost 100 telescope, 100 antennas like this. So radio antennas which will detect. So there are large radio antennas, 100 are almost clubbed together into a single array. Instead of having one antenna, they will have 100 antenna, and they will link all those antenna to form one. These all 100 antenna will link together, and it will act as one antenna. So that is the logic here. So that the detection capacity is high. So such a kind of an arrangement only helps us in taking the picture of the black hole, which was released few years back. The image of the black hole we got. So like that, various antennas which are located in four different parts of the world were clubbed together to make one. So that the focus is very large. So it is located in Karoo region. So again, this Karoo region, you can note it down. They can ask regions in news and country. So in that area, they can ask this question. So there is another survey called MITEY survey. So this MITEY survey utilizes the data from all over the world. There are lots and lots of giant telescopes all over the world. The data from all the telescopes will be going into this survey. With that data, one is directly seeing and observing. Another thing is getting the data and working it in the computer simulation and trying to identify if any galaxies are. So it is a offline work, like how we discussed yesterday. India did the nucleators, got the data. With the data, we can do in computer simulation. So the similar thing that is happening here with respect to MITEY. So data collected in Meerkat telescope will be used in MITEY survey. So that is what we discussed here. So MITEY's full form is GHTE is Gigahertz Tiered Mega Galactic Exploration. So that is a different thing. Okay. Square kilometer array means that all the telescopes which are located together, if you combine it, everything together, the total area of the the total area which is receiving the radio signal will be 1 square kilometer. So that is the logic here. So that much, it is not 1 square kilometer large telescope, small telescope combined together to form a 1 kilometer square large telescope. So that is the logic here. So next question, consider the following statements. Okay, radio galaxy. Just now we discussed what is a radio galaxy. It is a particular type of active galaxy that emits more light at radio wavelengths than at visible wavelengths. So than in visible spectrum, it emits more in the radio spectrum. That's why we are able to, visible thing is not coming, but radio signal is coming. They are extremely large galaxies with supermassive black hole in their center that actively accumulates gas and dust from its surroundings. Yes. So speciality of black hole, we have to study about the black hole. So why I'm telling is, in that year when the black hole was detected, there was a prelim question regarding black hole. So that's how the questions are working. So if there is a thing here, so this year we can get a question regarding radio galaxy. So that is how it is working. So you study about black hole, still they can ask. So these giant galaxies are much bigger than most of the other galaxies in the universe. They are thought to be quite rare. There are almost millions of radio galaxies in the universe, but we have detected only 800. Human beings have able to detect only 800 galaxies, but there are millions and millions of galaxies. So the next question is regarding Somnath Temple. The Somnath Temple in news because recently Prime Minister of India was appointed as chairperson of the Somnath Temple board. So this is second time in history. Earlier Morarji Desai, when he was Prime Minister, he was also the chairperson of the Somnath Temple board. So now, after Morarji Desai, our Prime Minister, the second Prime Minister to be the chairperson of a temple board. So it is built in the Chalukyan style. So where is Somnath Temple? Odisha. Mahabharata Madhadiliya. Dwaraka. Krishna Ode Ur Dwaraka. So it is Saurashtra, in the Saurashtra region, in the bottom side, Somnath. It is in the shore. It is a temple which is like Tiruchendur Temple. It is very near to the shore. So it is said that there was a Somnath temple during the time of Krishna also, but that Somnath temple got under the sea. So that's why they constructed another Somnath temple later. So that is the myth or belief or whatever you assume. It is cited as, So it is an interesting fact. The second statement is an interesting thing. It is cited in such a manner that no landmass can be seen from Somnath Sea Shore till Antarctica. If you see, of course, the Earth is curved. You cannot see. You will just see the shore. But in the map, if you could see from Gujarat till Antarctica, there is no landmass between them. So that is an added trivia which was given in the Indian Express. So they just took that. It is dedicated to Shiva and was plundered by Aurangzeb in 1025. It was plundered by Aurangzeb in 1025. See, Aurangzeb plundered it, yes. Not only Aurangzeb, from Ghazni to Aurangzeb, everyone plundered. But Aurangzeb lived in 18th, 17th century, not in the 11th century. In 11th century, 1005 is the time of Ghazni. So during the Ghazni's time, they plundered. It is said that, so this is Somnath temple. It is Chalukyan architecture. Whenever you are studying temple architecture, you have to know the differences. One is Dravidian, another is Nagara. A mixture of both Dravidian and Nagara is Dasara. So I hope you will be studying. So there is subcategories within the Dravida also. In Dravida, we are also having subcategories based on the shape of the Gopuram. Katu Shastra, Aya Shastra. So similarly, there are also subcategories under the Nagara. So in Nagara, we are having Gajapati or style or Chalukyan style. And then we are having Assam, Gowda style. So like this, we are having three different subcategories also. So in that, Chalukyan style is this variant. So we are having a similar kind of a construction for the Ram Mandir also, which is being planned. You study about this because UPSC asked a question regarding the Ram Mandir in CDS examination. So we have to study about that also. So this is the thing. See, from Sri Somnath Jyotirlinga temple till Antarctica, there is no landmass. But see, Indian Express la potirukpa what I will do illa irukadhu correct da see adu or irrational logic adu which is being given in Indian Express. So Earth is spherical, so from any point if you stand and see, you will just see the space only, you cannot see that. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi was elected as the chairperson of the, so chairman ngra word use panna kudadhu, chairperson, as the Sri Somnath Trust, religious body which manages and maintains the famous Somnath temple at Vera level illa Vera Wall in Gujarat. Vera Wall ngiradhu the city geography option, indha mari da neenga vandu edathalo note panikanum. Okay, so in the structure, it was having a golden structure, and the golden structure da vandu it was believed to be even. So it is built by Maitraka kings of Vallabhi kingdom oda kings da vandu, they constructed in the 7th century. So oror time la oror destruction nadandhoni thirupi kattuvaanga. So latest ah irukra ipo irukra temple oda construction 1950 la aarambichathu, oruga the structure vandu 50s la aarambichaanga. So andha temple oda structure da. So Ghazni oru vaati vandu he took it, and then we had in 1272 at that time vandu Deccan Sultanate la Tughlaq dynasty la oru vaati nadakkum, and then we had Aurangzeb. So kandipa vandu inda temple destruction pathi la or question varumaan therla, but still therinju vechikanum temple architecture pathi paathukonga. So next vandu X Desert Night 21. So X Desert Night 21 is a exercise between India and France. Like I already said, first thing you have to study between which two nations, second thing what you have to study, what kind, endha army idla varudhu, endha military varudhu, endha group, air force. So it is an air force evada exercise. Already Garuda nu onnu irukku, Garuda is another exercise between same India and France with for air force. So air force ku already onnu France kuda pandrom, Garuda um irukku, ipo vandu desert night vandu air force ke dhaan pandrom. So in the desert night vandu namma vandu Rajasthan la they were doing, both the air forces met and they were doing the interoperability. So Indian Air Force and French Air and Space Force. So avanga kitta space force irukadanal they are doing this. So it provides the operational exposure of both the air forces and combat capability. Now already told you what is the purpose of exercise. If both the armies in future, if they are having a situation to work together, they should know the procedure and protocol of each other. So that's why friendly nation will come together and do this exercise or drill. So already we are having Garuda. It is the first time ever the Indian skies will be hosting Rafale aircraft by both the sides. So avangalo avanga Rafale they are bringing, and we are also using a Rafale. So Rafale is being used, that is one thing, and Rafale also is going to make the debut in Republic Day parade this year. So that is one added fact. and the two air forces will be exchanging the ideas and best practices, enhancing the interoperability and putting into practice operational experiences. So this is the actually this is the objective of any military exercise whichever you are seeing. Consider the following statement regarding question R. So I took a question in a different way and this question is in a different way. There is no question R on the day president addresses the MPs from both the houses and finance minister presents the budget. Yes, that is true. On the budget day and on the president's address day, there is no question R. So when and all president will address the Lok Sabha or parliament? In what all occasions? President Mudinjithin sonnanga. Puriyala? After the election, first session la nadakkum, then budget illa. Every first session of an year. Ella yearum new year ku appuram nadakkara first session he will be addressing and every first session of a new government he will be addressing. So these are all the two special occasions. There is no question hour annik irukadhu. The first hour of every parliamentary sitting is slotted for question hour. That is true. The parliament starts at 11 a.m. 11 a.m. to 12 noon vandu we are having question hour. From 12 noon to 1 vandu we are having 0 hour. So after 1 p.m. they will go for lunch and they will meet again at 2 o'clock. So 2 o'clock la irundhu 6 o'clock or 5 o'clock varaikum vayasanavanga perusungalukku time edhu varaikum okkara mudiyudho adhu varaikum okkandhu they will be doing. Ella all perusungala dhaan irukku enna pandrathu youth kammiya dhaan irukanga. So 6 o'clock varaikum they will be sitting. This is the normal agenda for the day, but this new, because of this COVID-19 pandemic, we are converting all the three chambers into one because of the social distancing. So we are having three chambers, one for Lok Sabha, one for Rajya Sabha and one for joint sitting, that is central hall, which acted as constituent assembly. So all the three chambers are being used. So that's why morning session will be for Rajya Sabha and afternoon session will be for Lok Sabha. So like that they have divided the day. Morning Rajya Sabha will meet and in between till 2 o'clock Rajya Sabha will be doing. In between you are having 2 hours break and then 4 to 8 o'clock Lok Sabha will meet. So that is how they have planned this year's session. And question hour was suspended in the last monsoon session. Then question hour was suspended, this question hour was in use, but now they have decided, government got a very big outlash at that time for banning the question hour because it is one of the important tools used by the MPs to make the ministers accountable for whatever executive activities they are doing. So it is one important tool through which the legislature has a control over the executive. We all know parliamentary form of government la executive should be always responsible to legislature. So question hour la an MP can ask any question to a minister and minister should give the answer. So on the based on the whether it is starred or unstarred question, if it is a starred question, that minister should come to the house and give an oral answer. If it is an unstarred question, he can give the printout. They will be just printing and giving the answer. So supplementary question means once the question is being answered, then the person who asks the question is having the rights to ask a supplementary question, follow-up question. Or any other person also can ask a follow-up question. For that also the minister will be answering. So that is the brief thing. So I gave a three different kinds of statements. So what was the first statement? Actually, I gave the definition of 0 hour. So 0 hour is a it's an hour after the question hour, which is used to raise the issues of national importance. If any national important issue is going on, so it allows MP to raise the issues of national importance or the issues in their own constituencies. Okay, so if in central Chennai if there is any problem, then Dayanidhi Maran will use 0 hour to raise that issue. If there are some issue with respect to railways, means Dayanidhi Maran is our MP from central Chennai. So he will raise that issue in the 0 hour to the railway minister during the 0 hour. So that is the logic of 0 hour. Now, if at all now we are having 0 hour, then what they will do? All the MPs will be asking the question to defense minister regarding the China and the border, like that. So they will be using any issues of national importance, or they might also question the communication minister or home minister regarding the Arnab Goswami case, that Arnab Goswami terrorist case where he leaked the national sensitive information to another person. So that case was going on. So that is the first hour of every parliamentary sitting is slotted for the question hour. Okay, so that is the thing. The last statement is that if you are asking any question in question hour, you should give 15 days notice period, but with the permission of speaker you can ask the question even earlier to that also, without the notice period also. Generally 15 days before it they'll give the giving the question. So the ministers are having 15 days to prepare an answer. So if speaker allows, they can ask immediately also. So that provision is also there. So that's why the fourth statements were wrong there, the question which I posted in group. So question hour vandu it is there in the rules of procedure, but 0 hour is not there. 0 hour vandu Indian innovation, namma oorla adha kondu vandom. So short notice question la 10 days kammiyavum kudukalam. So idanalada and the fourth statement was wrong. What explains the eastward flow of equatorial counter current? So geography la whenever the question is coming, So 6 or 7 questions is coming in the past 5 to 6 years. Preliminary la past 5 to 6 years, 6 or 7 questions da varudhu. All 4 questions are going for the map. 2 questions da vandu conventional area la nu varudhu. On an average, and eppo na maarala UPSC predict panna mudiyadhu. So and the mari 2 conventional questions, the subject based question la, this is one question which came from the oceanography. Generally they'll ask those questions also. The pattern is, it is either from geomorphology or climatology or oceanography only. In the moon area la nu they are asking. So ocean currents nadathiyaacha ungalku. So what is the reason for the eastward flow of equatorial counter current? So this is ocean current, so this is equatorial current. This equatorial current will start in the equator and it goes near the shores. Once it it moves in the eastern direction, once it hits the continent, it will get accumulated here. See, penna avadu inge epdi thanni podu, inge epdi thanni podu. So we all know we are having trade winds here, right? There is trade winds like this. Climatology nadathidangala. So this trade winds will push the water to the western direction. So since the trade wind is going here, the water will come and merge here and move this way. So since it is moving this way, that is creating the equatorial current. When this water goes and hits the continent, the water will be accumulated, a large amount of water will be accumulated, because constantly water is moving westward, and you will be having accumulation of water in the western side of the ocean. So because of this accumulation, what will happen, if you could see the side view, the accumulation will be like this. This is the normal sea level, but accumulation of water will be like this. So once water is getting accumulated there, it will revert back. That reverting back of water is equatorial counter current. So and the equatorial counter current moving in the eastward direction. So rendu northern equatorial current, southern equatorial current irukum, nadula will be having the equatorial counter current. So that is the brief concept, but in detail they will be teaching in the geography classes. You can follow. You have to remember each and every ocean currents given in all the oceans. Indha maari nariya ella ocean currents kandipa padikkanum. Know the name. எந்த ஓஷன் கரண்ட் எங்க இருக்கு, கொரோஷியோ, வேர் இஸ் கொரோஷியோ, ஆர் வேர் இஸ் கேனரிஸ் கரண்ட், வேர் இஸ் பெனிகுலா, ஈச் அண்ட் எவ்ரி நேம் ஹாப் டு நோ. வெதர் இட் இஸ் ஹாட் ஆர் கோல்ட், அது வந்து ஹாப் டு நோ. ப்ளூ மீன்ஸ் கோல்ட் அண்ட் ரெட் மீன்ஸ் ஹாட். ஸோ இதெல்லாமே ஜியோகிராஃபியில தெல் பி டீச்சிங் அண்ட் யூ கேன் நோ. ஸோ டி இஸ் த, ஸோ வாட் இஸ் த ரீசன், நீங்க என்ன ரீசன்னா இங்கே கொடுத்துருக்க ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் போவோம். ஸோ ரொட்டேஷன் ஆஃப் தி எர்த் ஆக்சிஸ் கிடையாது, கன்வர்ஜன்ஸ் ஆஃப் டூ இக்குவட்டோரியல் கரண்ட்ஸ்னால, கன்வர்ஜன்ஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ளூ இக்குவட்டோரியல் கரண்ட்ஸ்னால தான் we are getting the equatorial current. So equatorial rendu trade winds converge aradunala we are getting the equatorial current. Difference of salinity, salinity has no role here. Occurrence of the belt of calm. So what is the, na appa enna sonna na, there is this accumulation of water near the continent sonnala. Since the doldrum region nu solluvanga in the equator, since this doldrum region is a calm region, there is no larger amount of winds there that allows the water to come back. If there is wind, then water will go in some other direction. Since there is no water there and the water is calm there, it is coming back. So that is the logic. Actually in that year there was a controversy between B and D, which is the right answer. So B la enna solranga, rendu convergence of two equatorial currents north to south um poittu continent la converge aaradunala dhaan the bulge is forming and coming back engra mari one argument was given, but UPSC ki la D nu irukku. So that's why D ku vandu, D is also the right one, but here they appo dhaan therinjadhu UPSC is meaning the trade winds convergence here. So that is the logic. So இது ரொம்ப சிம்பிள் க்வெஸ்சன் தான். தே ஆர் ஜஸ்ட் டெஸ்டிங் ஹவு வெல் யூ ஹவ் அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் தி கான்செப்ட். ஜியோகிராஃபில இருந்து எப்போ க்வெஸ்சன் வந்தாலும் இட் வில் பி வெரி சிம்பிள். ஓகே, சோ வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் எனி டவுட்ஸ் வித் ரெஸ்பெக்ட் டு தீஸ் 10 க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ்? எஸ், சோலாங்கி டைனாஸ்டில பீமதேவா பிளண்டர்ட் இட். ஓகே, எனி அதர் க்வெஸ்சன்? 10 க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் ஓகேவா? சோ ஷல் வி கோ டு தி டாஸ் க்வெஸ்சன்? சோ தி மெயின்ஸ் க்வெஸ்சன் ஃபார் தி டே இஸ் ரிகார்டிங் The rise of unauthorized colonies in Indian cities, especially in Delhi, is a disaster in making. So in the question vandu it is regarding what, which area syllabus la, in the area enga disaster management. Okay, so disaster gra vada. Okay, apro infrastructure. Okay, migration. Okay, migration gra vada iruka nama syllabus la. Urbanization. GS paper one la directly we are having this word called urbanization. Okay, we are directly having this word called urbanization. So in GS paper one, urbanization, unauthorized colonies in Indian cities. Here unauthorized colonies na edha mean pandranga na, slum development. One side la slum development sollalam, that is also not authorized, but it is increasing. Another side vandha nam unauthorized colonies nu, what we can mean is it is unpermitted construction. If a building needs to be constructed, means there are certain rules. You should not construct above this many levels of floors. Based on the soil, they will tell the depth of the foundation, and they will also mandate that there should be gap between the two buildings. But if you could see in some settlements, there won't be any gap. They have, both the houses will have a common wall. So without any gap, they would have constructed. So those kinds of constructions are all called as unauthorized colonies. So one with respect to slum development, another with respect to congested construction of cities. So in these two dimensions, we can see that. So it is an effect of urbanization, because a lot of people are moving, like he said, migration. A lot of people are moving to the urban area or in search of job. So they are not having the place. So in one small city, 1 crore people are living. So we are not having the space. So we are, the constructions are getting congested. Since not everyone can get good jobs, they are not having enough money. So the slum is getting developed. So we can handle this question in two ways. And they are also giving, especially Delhi. So they are also telling in Indian cities and especially in Delhi. So in both the aspect, we have to answer. Some might focus only on Delhi, or some might focus in general in cities, but it should not do that. We have to write in general, and we should also write with respect to Delhi also. Both the things you have to address, because the question also talks about that. It is a disaster in making. So how unauthorized colonies of Indian cities are a disaster. So that is the dimension. So here first we can write with the introduction. In introduction, what we can do? In introduction, we can talk about the level of, we can give a fact regarding the number of slums. So almost 17 million Indians are living in slums. So we can give this data. எத்தனை ஸ்லம்ஸ் இருக்குன்னு, ஆர் வி கேன் கிவ் இந்த மாதிரி அன்ஆதரைஸ்டு காலனிஸ் வந்து இப்போ டெல்லியில் ஒரு ஃபேக்ட் சொல்லுவோம், 1/3 ஆஃப் தி டெல்லிஸ் ஸ்பேஸ் இஸ் அன்ஆதரைஸ்டு காலனிஸ் தான். டெல்லியோட 1/3 ஆஃப் தி ஸ்பேஸ் இஸ் அன்ஆதரைஸ்டு காலனி. ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி கூட ஒரு ஃபேக்ட் வி கேன் ரைட் அண்ட் வி கேன் ஸ்டார்ட் தி கொஸ்டின். 1/3 ஆஃப் தி டெல்லி இஸ் அன்ஆதரைஸ்டு காலனி. ஸோ தட் இன்க்ரீசஸ், ஸோ தட் மேக்ஸ் தோஸ் சிட்டிஸ் வல்னரபிள் ஃபார் த்ரெட். ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி சொல்லி வி கேன் ஸ்டார்ட் அண்ட் இன்ட்ரோடக்ஷன். ஸோ எடுத்த உடனே நம்ம என்ன பண்ணலாம், அன்ஆதரைஸ்டு காலனிஸோட ரைஸ் எப்படிங்கிறது எழுதலாம். ஸோ நெக்ஸ்ட் வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பார்ட் ஆஃப் தி க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் ரைஸ் ஆஃப் அன்ஆதரைஸ்டு காலனிஸ் கேன் பி ஆன்சர்ட் ஹியர். ஹேண்ட் ரைட்டிங் இஸ் நாட் குட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தி சாஃப்ட்வேர். ரைஸ் ஆஃப் தி அன்ஆதரைஸ்டு காலனியோட ரீசன்ஸ் என்னென்ன? ஸோ வாட் இஸ் த ரீசன்ஸ்? ஒன் இஸ் மைக்ரேஷன், ஒன் இஸ் புவர் பிளானிங் பை அர்பன் அட்மினிஸ்ட்ரேஷன், then lack of job and poverty nala they couldn't afford to construct a good construction, then vandu lack of inspection from the administration, then purila population, yeah population adhigama irukkanaala land resources are restricted but population is increasing every year, vera resources, yeah resource crunch irukku. So innoru mukkiyamaana vishayam enna na, they will not be having the access to drinking water, sewage adoda access la irukadhu. ஸோ அந்த மாதிரி ரைஸ் ஆஃப் அன்ஆதரைஸ்ட் இதுக்கான ரீசன்ஸ் ஃபஸ்ட் எழுதலாம். ஸோ இந்த ரைஸ் எழுதுறப்போ வி கேன் டூ த யூஸ் த டிஃப்ரெண்ட் கைண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ரெசன்ட். இந்த மாதிரி ஏதாவது போட்டு எழுதலாம், ஆர் இந்த மாதிரி வந்து ரைஸ்ன்னு போட்டு இந்த மாதிரி மாடல்லையும் எழுதலாம் போட்டு கேன் ரைட். ஸோ நெக்ஸ்ட் பார்ட் ஆஃப் தி க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் ஹவு தட் ரைஸ் இஸ் ஹேப்பனிங் இன் இந்தியன் சிட்டிஸ் அண்ட் ஹவு இட் இஸ் ஹேப்பனிங் இன் டெல்லி. ரெண்டுத்தையும் நம்ம தனித்தனியாக கூட எழுதலாம். இன் ஜென்ரல் இந்தியன் சிட்டிஸ் பற்றி எழுதிட்டு, what in specific you can write regarding Delhi is, Delhi is a capital territory. So then, since it is a capital territory, it will have huge demand for jobs, and it will have huge opportunities for employment. So people will be migrating. So migrating pull factor will be generally higher with respect to Delhi. So on the reason all people will be moving there. Another problem with respect to administrative problem with respect to Delhi is land is not under the control of state government. So adanalu and the state government is not having enough power to regulate it. So land is in the control of central government for Delhi. So US lo kuda adha or problem. So there was an editorial explaining how the administration in the capital problem enna aachu. Washington DC riots pochala, they stormed the capital. So because of the dual control, and the dual control patti Delhi la innum konja specific ah eludalam. And you can also talk about the population. If other cities might be located in different area, but Delhi is located in plain. So on the plains ingradanala, in plains generally the population will be high. So geographical also we can see that. So on the mari elidittu, then we can talk about the disaster, how it is disaster in making. So disaster in making epdi? So disaster in making na, so idu vandu rendu dimension la eludanam. In the unauthorized colonies vandu it is creating the disaster. So innu vandu epdi vandu in the disaster or further affecting the unauthorized colony, அன்ஆத்தரைஸ் காலனினால எப்படி டிசாஸ்டர் வருது, டிசாஸ்டர்னால எப்படி உங்களுக்கு திருப்பி வருது. இந்த டயக்ராம் போட்டு ரெண்டு ஆஸ்பெக்ட் கூட வீ கேன் ரைட். அன்ஆத்தரைஸ் காலனினால எப்படி டிசாஸ்டர் வருது, இஃப் யூ குட் சி இஃப் த கூவம் இஸ் ஃப்ளட்டட் ஆர் அடையார் இஸ் ஃப்ளட்டட் ஹூ வில் பி அஃபெக்டட், தோஸ் பீப்பிள் தோஸ் ஸ்லம்ஸ் லொக்கேட்டட் ஆன் தி பேங்க்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி கூவம் வில் பி அஃபெக்டட். ஸோ இஃப் எனி டிசாஸ்டர் டேக் பிளேஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பீப்பிள் டு கெட் அஃபெக்டட் இஸ் தெம். ரீசென்ட்லி தேர் வாஸ் அ ஹியூஜ் ஃபயர் இன் டெல்லி. ஒரு டெல்லியில வந்து ஒரு ட்ரேட் ஏரியாவில் தேர் வாஸ் அ ஃபயர் ஒரு மார்க்கெட்ல, அண்ட் லாட் ஆஃப் பீப்பிள் ஆர் ட்ராப்ட் இட். So because of this unauthorized construction alla steps staircases oda width kammiya irundadanaala they couldn't 100 per vandu iranga mudiyala at the time la. So that's why they were trapped in the fire. So indha mari vandu unauthorized construction alla people that will lead to disaster, natural disaster andala nariya per ena more number of people will be living in a vulnerable area. So if there is a disaster more number of people will be affected in the same area. So andha mari vandu vulnerability is also getting increased. So flood endha or disaster adhe mari vandu Delhi pathi eludrona Delhi is an earthquake prone region. So four region 4 la of the seismic demarcation la fourth level la irukku. So apdi irumbodhu again the vulnerability for the earthquake is also increasing. So earthquake adhigama irukna the construction should be earthquake resilient, but indha mari congested constructions vandu whether it is earthquake resilient or not, that is another dimension which we can write. How it is a disaster in making, how this disaster will further aggravate and the aspect eludittu we can do. Since it is common you are open right in any way. So conclusion la eludrappo you have to be solution oriented. How we can be solution oriented? Increase the power devolution to the urban local bodies. So who should regulate all this, CMDA or corporation? So you have to increase, you know, it is about cities or not corporation. So increase the power given to them. State government is reluctant in sharing the power. State government will talk about federalism when it is fighting with center, but it will forget about federalism when it's talking when we are talking about urban local bodies or rural local bodies, panchayat. So since like how they are expecting the powers from the center, they should also dwell the powers to the urban local bodies and increase their power to implement all these things. That is one thing. And then they can do the inspection panni fining andha mari panna da vandu they can implement the regulation, because all the regulations are there in paper, but still people will be constructing. So like that we can give a way forward and end this. So conclusion la vandu we can talk about that aspect. So clear ah? Any doubt in this question? Okay, any doubts for those in the online, or any doubts here online la irukavangal edha doubts iruka? See adu CAG oda report or public accounts committee in the report ellame they will submit it to president. Finance commission report ellame president submit pannuvanga. President will submit that report in the parliament. அது வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் செஷன் ஆஃப் தி டே நடக்கணும்னு இல்ல. வென் எவர் தே ஆர் கெட்டிங் த ரிப்போர்ட், வென் எவர் தி அசம்பிளி இஸ் மீட்டிங், ஹி வில் சென்ட் அண்ட் சப்மிட். பிரசிடென்ட் வந்து பிசிக்கலா வந்து சப்மிட் பண்ணுவாருங்கிறதுலாம் இல்ல, பிரசிடென்ட் ஆஃபீஸ்ல இருந்து அந்த ரிப்போர்ட் வருங்கிற அந்த ஒரு விஷயம் தான் அது. ஜென்ரலி இங்க இப்ப என்ன நடக்கணும்னா, நீங்க இப்ப வந்து இட் இஸ் அன் ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டி ஃபார் யூ ஆல் கைஸ், ஜஸ்ட் யூ ஆர் ஸ்டார்டிங் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் அட்டம் நடந்து இப்பதான் பார்லிமெண்ட் செஷன் ஒன்று பார்க்க போறீங்க. சும்மா பார்லிமெண்ட் செஷன் பாருங்க டிவியில, டிவியில வந்து ஒரு ஹாஃப் அன் அவர் 15 மினிட்ஸ் சும்மா என்ன ஓடுதுன்னு பாருங்க, இல்லைனா யூடியூப் சேனல்ல இப்போ வருது, யூ கேன் சீ தட். முடிச்சிடறேன் சோ என்ன சொல்ல வரேன் முடிச்சிடறேன். சோ அந்த இது பாருங்க, அப்படி பாத்துட்டு இருக்கிறப்போ இந்த மாதிரி விஷயங்கள்லாம் நோட் பண்ணுங்க. சோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டே பிரசிடென்ட் வந்து ஸ்பீச் கொடுப்பாரு ஜாயின் சிட்டிங்கு, ஸ்பீச் முடிச்ச உடனே 29 ஆரம்பிக்குது, 29, 30, 31 மூணு நாள் இருக்கு. மூணு நாள் என்ன, அடுத்த ரெண்டு நாள் என்ன நடக்கும்னா, முதல் நாள் வந்து ஸ்பீச் முடிச்சுட்டு போயிடுவாங்க, அடுத்த நாள் வந்து அவரோட ஸ்பீச்சை டிஸ்கஸ் பண்ணுவாங்க. ஸோ பிரசிடென்டோட ஸ்பீச்ல என்ன இருக்கும், அச்சீவ்மெண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி கவர்மெண்ட் இந்த லாஸ்ட் இயர் அண்ட் ப்ராஜெக்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி கவர்மெண்ட் இந்த ஃபியூச்சர். அதுதான் அதை வந்து ஒரு ஹிண்ட் மாதிரி கொடுப்பாரு, ட்ரெய்லர் மாதிரி. அச்சீவ்மெண்ட்ஸ் என்னென்னலாம் நடந்திருக்கு, போன வருஷம் என்னென்ன பண்ணோம், இந்த வருஷம் என்னென்னலாம் பண்ணலாம்ங்கிற மாதிரி ஐடியாஸ் கொடுப்பாரு. இந்த பிரச்சனை இருக்கு, அந்த பிரச்சனை இருக்கு, அதெல்லாம். ஸோ ஜென்ரலாக வந்து தட் இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் எனி ஆக்ட் டன் பை தி பிரசிடென்ட் இஸ் நாட் ஃப்ரம் இஸ் ஓன், இட் இஸ் த ஒன் விச் இஸ் கமிங் ஃப்ரம் தி கவர்மெண்ட் தான். எவ்ரி திங் இஸ் எய்ட் அண்ட் அட்வைஸ் தான், பிரசிடென்ட் டிஸ்கிரிஷனே கிடையாது. ஸோ பேஸ்ட் ஆன் த எய்ட் அண்ட் அட்வைஸ் ஒன்லி ஹி வில் பி ஆக்டிங். ஸோ அது முடிஞ்ச உடனே மூணு நாள் அந்த டிபேட் முடிஞ்சு பிரசிடென்டோட ஸ்பீச்சை வந்து பாஸ் பண்ணணும், லோக்சபாவில் பாஸ் ஆகிடும், ராஜ்யசபாலையும் பாஸ் பண்ணிடுவாங்க. பட் ஜென்ரலாக அது ஒத்துப்பாங்க, அது பாஸ் பண்ணலன்னா கவர்மெண்ட்டுக்கு இதுங்கிறதுனால தே வில் பி பாஸிங் இட். அதில் ஏதாவது அமெண்ட்மெண்ட்ஸ் பண்ணணும்னாலும் பண்ணுவாங்க. ஸோ அது முடிச்சுட்டு நெக்ஸ்ட் டே தான் வந்து பட்ஜெட் இருக்கும். இதுக்கு முன்னாடி ரயில்வே பட்ஜெட் ஒன்று இருந்தது, இப்போ சின்ஸ் தே ஹவ் மெர்ஜ்ட் இட் வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் ஒன்லி ஒன் பட்ஜெட் ஆன் February 1st. சொல்லுங்க. ஓகே, ஷால் யூ வைண்ட் அப் ஃபார் தி டே. வேறு ஏதாவது டவுட்ஸ் இருந்ததுன்னா கேன் போஸ்ட் இன் த கமெண்ட் செக்ஷன். தேங்க்யூ. ஸோ ஐஆர் கிளாஸ் ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் அட் 9:30.